Hello YouTube. I've gotten a lot of questions about my color scheme and thought I'd make a quick video addressing it. So here I have re-stickered owlongs, a white and a black, obviously. And I'll go through these in a minute, but what I want to start with was my standard color scheme. A lot of people have asked me about it. My basic scheme is black on bottom, gray on top, full brights for the sides. Usually I have my G logo sticker on the bottom. And this is obviously for a white cube. And this is actually a Zanchi. This is probably my favorite cube. If I had a main, I guess this would be it. not sure how clear the lighting or color is going to come through here. Through the viewfinder, the orange is a little muted. The other colors are pretty true, but this is my standard color scheme. The rest of this video is going to focus on particular shades of some of these colors, but before getting there, I thought it was worth pausing and talking about why this scheme at all. For starters, I like white cubes. I'm not sure why, but I like them. And for me at least, if you're going to go to a white cube, I prefer to have black stickers on the bottom, which is very similar to having white stickers on the bottom of a black cube, just that stark contrast for your cross color. For the four sides, I keep the same standard scheme, which is, you know, blue, red, green, orange, but I prefer the bright shades, fluorescent, bright, whatever you want to call them. I just find the standard Rubik shades, or whatever you want to call it, to be kind of boring and drab and muted, and sometimes they have trouble contrasting from one another. So I prefer brights just as a way of having contrast, and I just find it aesthetically more pleasing. From there, the big question is why gray? And I like gray because it contrasts against the white while also contrasting against the black. But it's even more than that. Yellow would normally be on top, and the problem I find with yellow is a different color than the other colors, but it has a brightness, it has a hue, it has color to it. And in certain lighting or just doing things quickly, yellow is really not that different than some of the other colors. You know, there's all this color on top. For example, if you're at the OLL stage here, where I think if you're at the OLL stage with gray on top, these sort of disappear. And you see what's not flipped, or, you know, what's not oriented. So I prefer that. And I think the same is sort of true during cross and F2L. You know, these cross colors are very obvious. You know, when you're sitting here, I'll just hand scramble this. And it's very easy to find the cross colors to start setting it up, which... which, you know, then when you get to the F2L stage, these corners really stick out, the black corners. And again, what's disappearing is the gray. And so you're seeing black as a corner, and I'm seeing colors, the gray disappearing compared to, compared to colors, which you don't want to worry about when you're doing F2L. So I don't know. I mean, maybe that was just a really quick explanation. Maybe it doesn't make sense to you. For me, it makes a lot of sense. I go into more details about this on my blog, but for me, it just works. And actually, one of the main reasons maybe I like it, it sounds silly, but it's just that it's different. And I like having a scheme that's sort of, for lack of a better word, mine. So anyway, that's just something I wanted to get to before we get to the shades. And we can talk about shades now. Until recently, I got all of my stickers from the cube specialists in Germany. And I really like these stickers. But recently, with new cubes coming out and new shapes, these are fitted where the corners clipped, but they're not curved and they're not a little smaller to fit cubes like the Owlong. I've been wanting to find a different vendor, and the Cubicle is a great US vendor. It's where I buy most of my puzzles. And they've got this great sticker picker. So I started buying stickers from the Cubicle recently. The quality's great. And I like the fact that they're cut for all these different puzzles. And I really like supporting them. It's actually the sticker picker that I think is the biggest attraction, because it allowed me to adjust, as I'm going to do now, and create my own sets. The Fulbright sets that come from the Cubicle don't have black for the bottom, and neither has gray for the top. So given that I like that, the sticker picker is really useful. The other reason I really like the sticker picker was, as much as I like the green, red, and orange that come in the Fulbrights, the blues that come in the Fulbrights I really don't like. Let's take a second to look at the different blues that I have on here. I stickered both of these. I'll just use the black one for now. I stickered both of these with the standard Fulbright shade for the E-layer. That's this one. It's called Fluorescent Blue. So that's the standard Cubicle fluorescent or bright shade. The D layer I stickered with light blue, and the U layer I stickered with sky blue. Now I'm not sure how much you can see these differences through the viewfinder. They're very subtle. I'll take pictures with a good SLR to try and show you. But the D layer is a little bit lighter than the original Moyu shade, which is still there. The original Moyu shade is almost identical to sky blue. And then again, these lighter ones that I actually call powder blue is what the Cubicle calls fluorescent blue. I don't like those at all. I'm torn between the sky blue on top or the light blue on the bottom. I prefer the light blue as I bring green over to look at contrast. It's a very subtle difference, but the light blue I prefer. So I'm going to re-sticker this so that all of this face is light blue. I'll do both of the cubes, but before I do that, I just wanted to go over the shades really quickly and compare them to the Moyu shades, which I think people are becoming familiar with. We just did the blue face. On the orange face, the orange that comes from Moyu is a little bit more peachy, a little bit more pink, if that makes sense, that's the center cap compared to the orange that surrounds it. Light green, or the fluorescent green, I should say, is almost identical to the Moyu shade. The center caps here are Moyu, and there's a very, very slight difference with the Moyu being slightly less saturated, but otherwise they're really, really close. The reds, there is a very big difference. The center caps, the original Moyus, are more like a tomato red, a little dark, compared to the really bright fluorescent shade that comes in the bright sets from the Cubicle. And then we already talked about blue. Obviously white and black are white and black. And this is a gray, same gray on both of them. There's a light gray. The light gray was very, very close to white. It wouldn't have worked on the black cube. And here we are, through the magic of editing, back with the Owlong. I had thought when I showed this it would be fully stickered. I did obviously finish stickering the blue. Through the viewfinder, it looks like it's all one color. It's actually not the case. I'll explain in a second. But I had stickered the entire cube, or the entire side, light blue, which, as I said, I thought was misnamed. The light blue is actually really basically a fluorescent blue, and I thought it matched the other fluorescent or bright shades better. And after I did that and I was cleaning everything up, I realized that I'd actually missed a Cubicle shade called ocean blue, which was almost identical, just a bit more saturated, and that little bit of extra saturation made it more fluorescent and made it match the other colors better. So I went back and re-stickered half of this face, this QB, this, and this, and I left the T here in the light blue. Now through the viewfinder, it looks absolutely identical. I cannot tell the difference between the shades. As soon as I look past the viewfinder, I can see, dramatic isn't the right word, but I can see the difference. And I definitely much prefer the ocean blue. So I'm going to do this whole cube, or this whole face, in ocean blue. I've decided that ocean blue probably should be my shade for my bright sets. And through the magic of editing, here we are with the final fully stickered cubes. just to go over the shades once again, that is fluorescent green, fluorescent orange, ocean blue. This was the face that I spent a lot of time trying to find the right color for. And after really spending a lot of time on it, I think ocean blue is what I would call fluorescent blue, and it matches the bright sets the best. So ocean blue and fluorescent red. The bottoms are, on white cubes I use black, on black cubes I use white, and then I have my custom stickers from Oliver Nagy. The cubicle gray is pretty dark. It works fine on white cubes. You could tell the white plastic, the gray, and the black have plenty of contrast. On black cubes, I actually find it a little dark. And the challenge is that the cubicle only has two shades of gray right now. The light gray is just too light. It's very close to white. That wouldn't create enough contrast. I wrote to them. They wrote back and said they're probably going to start carrying different shades of gray soon. That would be nice because I could experiment with that and try different ones, see if it works. The last thing I wanted to mention, and I'll cut away here to screenshots, the Cubicle has this ability to create custom sticker profiles. And so what you do is you pick what kind of puzzle it is, six-sided, 12-sided, whatever it is. You pick the stickers that you, the colors you like, and it stores them. And the nice thing is that makes it easier to order again in the future. But the other cool thing is you get a link and you can share the link. So I'll put a link in the description to my two schemes, whether it's white on the bottom or black on the bottom. And you can go check those out. It should make it easier for ordering. I'll also put a link to my Mega Minx sticker sets. And also we'll put a link to the video of me restickering the Mega Minx. I spent a lot of time trying to find the right 12 color mix for Mega Minx, and I really liked those. So that's it. Cutting back here to the cubes. I like the way these came out. I'll checkerboard them. And you can see the colors I don't think are that true through the viewfinder, but hopefully those SLR pictures that I showed earlier helped. This was probably a longer video than it needed to be to just go over sticker shades. But having taken the time to explore them, I thought I would just show them. There you are. Thanks for watching, and see you soon. Oh, sweet mama.